remember Fogarty. He was here a couple of years ago trying to get our vote.
Oh, yeah, he bought me a beer.
Did you vote for him?
He bought me a beer.
Something has to be done, and the time is now.
There he goes, spouting a bunch of meaningless platitudes. Sure enough, the people are lapping it up like milk. Oh, the mentality of the voter in this country fascinates me. Someday I ought to do a paper about it.
What's your problem with Fogarty? He's not a bad guy.
Oh. All right, Sam, why don't you ask him a question? I'll bet you $10 only gives you some meaningless politician's rhetoric.
Yeah, all right. Come on, you're on. Excuse me, Mr. Fogarty, sir. Can I speak to you for a second?
Mm-hmm.
I'm Sam Malone. I'm the owner of the bar. Got a question for you. I'm a small businessman, and I was just wondering, when is this economy going to turn around?
I'm glad you asked that. I say now is the time to roll up our shirt sleeves and get to the bottom of this. The only way we're going to defeat this thing is if we all do it together.
I think you owe me $10.
Hi, Kevin Fogarty, City Council. Kevin Fogarty, City Council. I hope I have your vote on Election Day.
And why exactly should I vote for you, Mr. Fogarty?
Well, because I'm a hard worker. I take a stand.
On what exactly?
The issues of the day.
Which are?
The things that concern you and your family the most.
I think you're making it out of yourself.
I simply want the councilman to say one concrete thing.
Yes, I understand. You don't trust me. A lot of people don't trust politicians. I know how it is. I have been out there.
What does that have to do
May
with...
May I finish, please? Maybe we need someone to blame. Maybe if we pick some faceless person at City Hall to be responsible for all our problems, then we won't have to accept any responsibility at all. Well, people, I say now is the time to start looking in the mirror. Because if this thing is going to work, we are all going to have to make it work. The way a bunch of people made something work at Lexington and Concord. You may remember it. It's called America.
Yes! But he didn't say anything! Thank you, people, for proving my point. The voters of Boston are sheep.
Well, I thought that was just a Hanover thing.
Look, all I'm saying is that when it comes to voting, people just shut off their brains. I submit we could put a chimpanzee on the ballot and garner 10% of the vote.
Oh, two Hanover things in one day?
You're exaggerating a little bit, aren't you?
No, Sam, I'm not. Look, you know what? I'll go you one better. I'll bet we could put Woody on the ballot and get 10% of the vote.
Yeah, all right, I'll take $10 of that.
All right, you're on.
You know, come to think of it, this would make a fascinating study of voter psychology. I submit if we just put Woody's name on the ballot, circulate a few posters of his attractive, smiling face over some meaningless slogan, come Election Day, we'll get 10% of the vote.
Oh, come on, man.
Oh, okay, I'll prove it to all of you. I'll start the process of getting his name on the ballot this very afternoon.
I don't know, Dr. Crane. I'm not so sure I want to get mixed up in all this.
Mixed up?